What's good, guys? It's really late at night, but I still want to get out the content for you. I missed this game live because Lefties and Snow played 2 or 3 hours after the scheduled time. I was around on Smogtooth at the scheduled time, but they weren't there. So we'll just watch the replay. Snow brought a mega episode, which is really cool. He will get some style points for that for sure. We will just put it on like normal so it's not too fast. He leads off with Absol. I don't know if he predicted Lefties to lead with Jirachi, but this is just a free knockoff. And I think he gets rid of the scarf on Kelly. You already watched this replay once, but I don't remember everything because I'm like retired. Recorded a live with my friend T earlier, but we lost the footage. I'm pretty sure Lefties just fired off a secret sword here, even though this Toxapex is obvious. But he might have like thought Snow might predict him to double because Toxapex was so obvious. But Lefties could have just scored there, honestly. Snow doubles out here, predicting the Greninja into Faramosa. This is just a free U-turn to find out whether Lefties is bulky Landorus or offensive, or to get some chip on the Kelly. Lefties makes a mid-ground in case Snow wants to Ice Beam, predicting Lando, I guess. I guess that's a good mid-ground to go Kelly on a U-turn. But yeah, Kelly is already below 50, and it's just a free switch into Tapu Bulu. I think this Tapu Bulu is banded. From, if I recall correctly, he just doubles out here. What did he predict? I think he predicted Jirachi. That's like the only switch in. Jirachi or Magnezone. So he doubles into Absol. He gets a knockoff on the Kelio. Gets more chip off. And I think he just goes back into Toxapex here. And this time Lefties just fires off. He doesn't fire off anything. He predicts. I don't know what he predicted there. Let me actually think about this turn for a thing. Nah, I really have no idea what Lefties was predicting there. He just, I don't know why he doubled into Mimikyu. The Toxapex is so obvious. Toxapex beats Mimikyu, so he has to switch again. Goes into Greninja. I thought this would be a free T-spec for Snow, but he goes Garchomp here, which is a really nice play. I'm pretty sure he went into Garchomp here predicting the Magnezone, because Magnezone comes in on T-spec or on Scald from Toxapex and just gets up a huge hit, but Snow tried to go Garchomp and catch that, but Lefties went Ninja instead. I think Lefties gets up a free spike here since the Garchomp is scared out by a potential Ice Beam. So we will see really soon. This is Bedef Toxapex, as it takes absolutely nothing from this Dark Bolt's Protein Greninja. I love this set. HP Fire is so good, like on Greninja. Skull does nothing, but he gets the burn. And I think Lefties just gets up another spike here. He doubled out again into Chomp, predicting the zone, pretty sure. Because the zone is like pretty free here. And Greninja doesn't beat the Pex, so Snow tried to get some advantage, but it didn't work out. Lefties just went for another spike. And I think Snow just went goes back here into Toxapex. Yeah, exactly. On a Hydro Pump, eats it up. And the Greninja like, gets chipped by the burn life orb. This time he makes a Jirachi play, which is like a bit confusing to me. I don't know what he was predicting there, and I really don't know what like what either player was predicting there. Like going to Absol, I don't really get that either. Like he, it works out. It looks like he predicted a Jirachi, but he could have gone Magnezone. Like I thought Magnezone was like more obvious, but this is another knockoff for Snow, and the Ninja gets picked off. I really don't know what to commentate on this since it's not live. I really like cannot give my thoughts that well, honestly. As this player of myth is huge, as we will find out really soon. This is Rocky Helmet, Garchomp, and he just has to take Rough Skin Rocky Helmet on live or recoil, and Snow gets up Roxy, and we will see this as Endure. So Lefties has to take another round of life orb, Rough Skin and Rocky Helmet, and Snow makes a really cool play here. So Mimikyu would go down here to recoil damage, right? So this is why Lefties wants to save it, and Snow makes a really nice play knowing that the Mimikyu does anyway if it attacks. If it doesn't attack, he can go for Dragon Tail to like chip anything out and make it take rocks, right? So he makes a Dragon Tail play, which is really nice, drags out the Landorus, so makes the Jirachi and the Landorus take rocks at least. Thought that play was pretty cool. I mean, it only did 12% on Lando, but it's something. Lefties reveals HPI, so this Landorus was max defense probably, or near max defense to check opposing double dance Landorus. And I'm thinking like his Manazon's probably a Solvez, because look at what Tapu Koko does to his team if it has HP eyes. It just runs through it. Like, you need some chip on this. This is not a switch, and it can, like, revenge the Koko because it's Scarf. But yeah, this can revenge if it has disguise. But yeah, no go T-Bolt switching otherwise. So Manazon has to be AV in my opinion. Snow brings out this Formosa, and I'm pretty sure I would assume he goes for Ice Beam here. I really don't remember these turns. I only watched this replay once really fast. Yeah, Keldeo looks that burly. I think he is he's Z-move. And these are like plus speed nature. I'm not sure if he's Quiver Dance actually, if he's that set. Because you see that Z Focus Blast all up pummeling set used a lot of times with Quiver Dance. Pretty sure he just, yeah, he breaks disguise. Lefties goes for SD here, if I recall correctly, predicting like a switch into packs to weaken that maybe. And he has two live up hits left. This was like a 50-50 kind of. Not really, but like Lefties just goes for Shadow Sneak, predicting like in case the Formosa stayed in. The Shadow Sneak still did a good chunk to this because it's like more super death. And I think the Shadow Claw even picks it off, which is like a bit surprising. Because Mimikyu is not that strong. I was watching on Smogon's YouTube earlier. Alexander was PC for OST round 1. It was Mimikyu. It was Adamant. I don't remember if it was Life Orb, but it couldn't kill a Metagross from 51% or 52% with Shadow Claw, which is like really disappointing. Like, this thing is not as strong as I wish this thing was a bit stronger, because this guy is such a cool ability. I really wish they would make this thing like even more viable. It's like okay viable at the moment. So now this is a double down, right? Who just brings out his Mega Upsilon Jirachi. I don't know if he predicted that again. But he just gets a knockoff here. I think Lefty's goes to Manazon and gets knocked off. Oh, he gets Lando, never mind. Don't remember that correctly. And next turn he goes like, he suckered there, just making sure in case the Jirachi was Scarf. And next turn he just goes Jirachi scouting for Ice Beam. I don't know why he didn't go Manazon. But yeah, since the Jirachi didn't reveal leftovers yet, he might think it's Scarf, so. And he was at -1, so this might have left a sucker punch, so he switched out. And Lefty C builds a really cool set here, which is Icy Wind Jirachi. I'm thinking he might be Exit build. Maybe some other damage boosting item, I'm not sure, he's not Life Orb. And we will see T-Bolt really soon, which does nothing, so pretty sure this is like Max Bedev Cell Stealer. Flamethrower is a good chunk to Jirachi. Yeah, by the way, Lefty has everything named after McMagan, if you didn't realize yet. I think this was named Lord McMagan. Lord Mang, the Mimikyu is gaming. I don't remember the other names. So it's just Celestial out, like predicting a T-Bolt again, goes into Bulu. Pretty sure this is banned from the damage it will deal. You will like see soon. It has like a shit ton to Landris and it kills the Jirachi easily. I mean, Scarf might have picked this off too, not sure then cucked it. But I cucked the damage versus Landris. Cause I thought it was like a Scarf Bulu earlier. Because Snow's team isn't that fast, honestly. I guess he has Formosa and he has Sucker Punch on this. But this is Tank Jump, so the rest of his team is like slow, so I thought this would be Scarf. I mean, Formosa is really fast and he has Sucker Punch. I guess that's enough speed control. Depending, like, he might have predicted Lefties to bring more of a bulky offensive-ish team, as he kind of did, honestly, like Scarf, Keldeo and Greninja were his fastest mons. So this Magnezone can just pretty much click Flash Gun here, try to revenge this. As Snow just sex of his Celesteela to Flash Gun plus T-Bolt. I think it's a sweet kill, as it actually lifts the T-Bolt here. Magnezone gets a nice grassy terrain recovery. Sometimes mix it up and think it's leftovers. At least shitness doesn't really matter. That would have only done like a little bit to Magnezone, obviously. He maybe could have gone for Protect, gain some more health, but I don't think it mattered in the long run. And Lefties missed the Player off early, so yeah, the Hex is like, I don't know how much the Player off miss mattered. Snow pretty much wins at this point. He just clicks High Jump Kick here and then he clicks Ice Beam and he wins. But Pokemon is a really good game, so you guys might already know what happens here. He goes for High Jump Kick and he misses, which sucks a lot. His Formosa goes down. Like, Snow deserved to win this. He had this really cool team Mega Up, so I get some style points for this for sure. He says sorry. Knockoff does absolutely nothing. Like, considering it's like a boosted move, it's like, I think, 95 base power if you knock off an item and stab. That didn't do that much. Trapping Megan is trained too well or something, is what Lefty here says in the chat. T-Bolt just picks off the up, so. Yeah, Trapping Megan too lucky. So, Megan just. Lefty just. I already said Megan because everything is named after Megan. Lefty is just sex off his Landris here to get off the Intimidate, so Magnezone can live a Woodhammer, a Bandit Woodhammer. You can see this is Bandit because it kills the Lando from 64. I calc this Scarf would only do like 50 or 52 max. So he has to be Bandit. Or some other damage boosting iron, maybe Grass Plate or something like that. But I assume it's just Bandit. And you will see this is a shit ton. Like, it's minus 1 and it's at 26.72 Magnezone to resist. So let me calc that real quick for you guys to make sure it's... Okay, I'm really confused. I calced this and a Bandit Woodhammer would have blown this Magnezone away. And this is like defense invested. So, Lefty's Landers is probably not... Yeah, Lefty's Landers is not defensive. I just messed up. It's probably like Scarf Land or Offensive Land. Nah, did it reveal rocks? It's his only rocker besides Jirachi. He didn't get up rocks this game, so we don't know the rocker. But yeah, that has to be an offensive land. I was just mixing up my calcs and thought it was Bandit Bulu. But it's probably Scarf Bulu then. Or some other set. Like, Bandit does like still kill this Magnezone at 40% easily, even at minus 1. I was like a bit confused because I did this Kalk versus Landris and I did max defense Landris and I thought there's no way this Bulu is Scarf because it just didn't, like, the Kalk just didn't fit Scarf Bulu because it did way more to this Landris, so I thought it had to be Bandit. But yeah, the solution to my like miscalc is this Bulu is Bandit, it's not Bandit, it's Scarf, and the Landris was just offensive. I thought it was defensive. I don't know why I was talking about that's so long for no reason. I'm like really tired. It's 5 AM. I just want to bring you guys the content. And the reason I'm still up is I was trying to get Rex earlier. I played 60 games and then I got hexed out and then I choked. I deserved that honestly because I played 6 games at once and I fucked up. So yeah, gotta retry to get Rex the next day or so. In 2 days I'm gonna be busy tomorrow probably. So yeah, but coming back to this game, that hex is like really annoying. Just not really got some star points here. Yeah, Fresh can finish him off and they say GG in caps, which is funny. And Lefties takes the game. Let me just check real quick the score. I think the score is 1-0 for Lefties. Lefties is on the Fireboot Falcons if I recall correctly. I did a real fire live with my friend T earlier. In the UUT with Supersonic Skyspark Challenge Slim, but I recorded with a new program and I didn't really understand it and like my rendering program like couldn't work together with that program, so for some reason I lost that footage now. I can upload that for you with black thing at the, I don't know the English word for it, there's like a black, it doesn't look good, there's a black thing at the ending of the video. So yeah, I'm sorry that I lost that content. I will just record a new live tomorrow. The live wasn't the best anyway, we didn't play the best, but the live was funny, honestly. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. We'll be back with more SPL, hopefully live the next time. And yeah, this was even really nice to watch this game live, but yeah, cannot have it all the time. See you next time, friends. Thanks for the support, by the way. We hit 414 subs, I think, which is pretty amazing. So yeah, peace out, friends, and see you next time.